Hello students, I am Dr. Gajendra Purohit and you are watching my YouTube channel where I upload videos for Engineering Mathematics B.Sc. If you are preparing for any competitive exam where higher mathematics is asked, my YouTube channel is very helpful. I am uploading a lot of videos on discrete mathematics and I have started teaching graph theory in that. Students in graph theory, I am going to teach you that how we will find if two graph are isomorphic or not. And we will also discuss about if it is homomorphic. Okay, so students, let's start. We will discuss isomorphism of a graph. So listen, here is the definition that is given to us. It means that if we have two graphs, then there should be a 1-1 correspondence between the edges of those two graphs. And the endpoints, meaning the vertices of those two, should also have a 1-1 correspondence between them. Okay, but students, it is a bit difficult to find it. Then we have a way hereby which we can figure out whether the two graphs are isomorphic or not. The first thing is that the number of vertices in both graphs should be the same. Second one is the number of edges are also the same. In both of them, the edges should also be the same. And equal number of vertices with given degree. So, in both the graphs we have, the degree of the vertices that they have should be same. It means whatever degree is on this side, it should be on another side too. Okay? Last point is that vertex correspondence and edge correspondence should be valid. So, whatever we have here, I just said that whatever edges we have here, those should be in 1-1 correspondence, and their endpoints, meaning their vertices, those should also be in 1-1 correspondence, right? We will talk about example. See these two graphs, whether they are isomorphic or not. So, first of all, what we will check, we need to have the same number of vertices here. So, how many vertices do we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here we also have 5 vertices, right? Now, let's discuss how many should be the edges. They should be equal. So, here we have how many edges? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. We have 6 edges. This means that the edges are equal to. We will talk about an equal number of vertices with the given degree. The vertices we have, both of them should be what? The vertices that we have here, their degree, and the degree of the vertices there should be equal, right? For example, I want to explain what happens. Like, for example, here we have U, V, W, X and Y. So, the second graph that we have, I will take its degree, okay? I will take its vertices. Here we have P, Q, R, S and T, right? First of all, we talk about degree of the U, how much we have. What is the number of edges in it? Tell me, 3. So, degree of this will be 3 if we will talk about V here. So, degree of this will be 3. Let's talk about W. So, here the degree we have will be 2. If we talk about X, then degree will be 3. And if we talk about Y, then its degree will be 1. Like this, let's see P here. So, what is degree of P? Its degree is 2, right? If you haven't seen my previous videos, you can check them on iTab or on the link, which is in description, or you can check them in pinned comments. I have explained about degree and all in previous videos. Now, degree of P will be what? 2. Again, let's see Q. So, in Q, there are 3 edges. So, its degree will be 3, okay? In R, we will have 3. In S, we will have 3. And in T, we will have 1, okay? So, here we have a vertex of 1 degree. This is also vertex of 1 degree. Here we have 3 vertices of 3 degree, here 3 vertices of 3 degree. Here we have 1 vertex with 2 degree, here we have 1 vertex with 2 degree. That means, so third point in both is, it is satisfied. We should check this, that vertices should be 1-1 correspondence. And edges should also have 1-2-1 correspondence. First, let's see 1-1 correspondence between vertices. So, whenever we have vertices, in that we see for same degree. Yes, in 1-1 correspondence, we talk about same degree, okay? So, here we have a vertex of 1 degree, here we have 1 degree. Therefore, this means Y will be 1-1 correspondence with T. Like this. It will be 2 degree in W here and here it will be 2 degree. It means that W that we have will be 1-1 correspondence with P. Now, here we are left with 3, right? Here is 3 degree. Now, which of these are 1-1 correspondence with each other? So, next, let's understand concept of edges, right? See, here is Y. Y is correspondence with T. So, here S and V are connecting with Y. Degree of this is 3 and its degree is also 3. So, what does this V and S will be? They will be 1-1 correspondence. So, V will be 1-1 correspondence with S, right? Therefore, this V that is here will go with S, okay? Now, we are left with U and X. Here is U and X. And here is P and R. So, you can connect any one of these. Okay, I am telling you about concept of vertices, but after this I will teach you about edges. So, let's see what is it. But let's do this once. So, X, here we will have. It will be R. Now you might wonder, sir, R here and Q here. It can be here too. So I will tell you a trick. From 1-1 correspondence of edges, we can have idea that which one will go in which one. Students, if we interchange these two in correspondence of edges, then also that concept is being satisfied. So we can choose any option from both. So this was about 1-1 correspondence of vertices. Now I will tell you how to check 1-1 correspondence of edges. So here we have Y and W, right? So students, let's check Y and W. Here this is Y and this is W in our hands. There is no edge between these two. So there should be no edge between T and P either. Okay. Here this is T and P. There is no edge in them either. Right. Here is W and V. If we talk about this, this is W. This is V. Here we do not have any edge. In the same way, let's talk about P and S. So there is no edge in P and S. Like this. Let's talk about V and U. Here we have edge in between V and U. Therefore, we should have edge in S and Q. Right. We have edge in S and Q. It means it's fine. Students, now if we talk about U and X here, then U and X have an edge, so Q and R should have an edge. So Q and R will also have an edge. Even if you interchange this, there will still be a 1-1 correspondence between edges, okay? Meaning, both of these graphs will be isomorphic. Let's move forward. Let's see what is homomorphic graph. Homomorphic graph will be two graphs G and G dash are said to be homomorphic if they can be obtained from the same graph. We have a graph given to us. We added some vertices here or added them here. So this graph is actually being obtained from here. So all the graphs that we are obtaining from here, they all are homomorphic to each other. Is this clear? Now pay attention here. These are homomorphic, but they can be or cannot be isomorphic. So to check if they are isomorphic or not, you have to use the method I have explained. When you check these two graphs will not be isomorphic, right? I will tell you more ways to check. How we can check for isomorphic. So same, the number of vertices and number of degrees should be same. So the sequence of degree of vertices are same, but mapping of vertices are not same. If it is not same, then it means it is homomorphic, but not isomorphic in this case. You will see here, like as we have, if you check here, the vertices we have, their degree is. So basically, there is no 1-1 correspondence between the vertices and edges in these two. So this is not isomorphic. Is this clear or not? Let's move on. Now let's see this question. Show that the graph given below are not isomorphic. You have to prove that. These two graphs are not isomorphic with each other. If we have to check if the graph is isomorphic, first thing we need to check is that the number of vertex for both should be equal. Here 6 vertex, here is 6 vertex. So vertex is equal. We will talk about edges. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 edges here this side. We also have 5 edges, so the edges are also equal. Now we will discuss here that all the vertex we have, their degree should be what? It should be the same for both. So here, pay attention. Here we have U1, U2, we have U3, U4, we have U5 and U6, right? Now students, please see here we have V1, V2, here we have V3, V4 and we have V5. Let's see degree of U1. How much is this degree? It is 1, degree of U2 is 2, degree of U3 is 2. Here degree of U4 is 3, here degree of U5 is 1 and here degree of U6 is 1. In same manner, degree of V1 is 1, V2 has 2, it is connected to it, so 2. Degree of V3 is 3. It is connected to 3 edges, therefore 3. Degree of V4 is 1. Now students, the degree of V5 is 2. And what is the degree of V6? It is 1. Here we have 3 of 1 degree. Here we have 3 of 1 degree. Here we have 2 of 2 degrees. Here also we have 2 of 2 degrees. And for 3 degrees, we have 1 here. That means degrees of both is equal. Now we will talk about 1-to-1 correspondence of its vertex and edges. So here the U1, it will be correspondence with which vertex of this? Can you tell? So here the U1, see, it can be correspondence in 3 ways, U1 to V1, or it can go to V4, or it can go to V6, right? So let's take it to V1. Yes, you heard it correctly. We will take U1 to V1. Now students, please pay attention here. We know that its edge is connecting with the edge. It is of 2 degree and here the edge with which V1 is connecting is also of 2 degree. So this can go with this. Okay, now we will talk about U2, right? Now this is U2. If we talk about it, here U2 is 1 and here its degree is 2. Is this clear? So students, since this is correspondence with this part here, therefore edge of this should connect with edge of this. Okay. Now moving ahead, if we try to correspondence this with V2, problem we have is degree of this is 1 and degree of this is 3. But we should have equal corresponding degrees, right? So this simply means that U2 will not go with V2. So this possibility is cancelled. Listen, if you think that we can make U1 correspondence to V6, right? So if you connect it to V6, then the U2 that we have, that will be correspondence to V5. Is this clear? See, here we are getting 1, 2. and here for V5 it will be 3-1, right? Since it is 1-2 here and 3-1 here, therefore it is not 1-to-1 correspondence. Hence, it will not be isomorphic. Reason behind this, because there is no 1-to-1 correspondence between vertex and edges. Clear? Now let's move on. We will see the next question. Show that the following graph are isomorphic. Basically, you have to prove that these graphs are isomorphic. So first of all, we will see numbers of vertex. Here we have 10 vertex and here also we have 10 vertex. Therefore, vertex is equal. In the same way, if you check the edges, their edges will also be equal. Right? Now, students, here we will talk about the degree. You can see here degree of each is how much? It is 3. So degree of all the vertex we have is 3, 3, right? Here also the degree is 3, meaning the degree here is also the same. Now we will talk about 1-to-1 correspondence of edges and of vertex. We will check if edges and vertex are in 1-to-1 correspondence or not. So we will take anyone first. Let's say I take Y. So Y is correspondence with whom? It is with E, students. Let's suppose Y is correspondence with E, okay? Now we will take U, since Y is connected with U. So students, if here Y is with U, therefore this side E is connecting with whom? It is connecting with B. So we will take B. Clear? Now we talk about V, okay? Because U is connecting with V. So this side B is connecting with D, so I will take it as D. Is it clear? Now you can see next it is going on W. So students, this side D is going to A, therefore we will take A. Now after W, here will be X. And this side after A, C will come. So this will be C. Is this clear? Right? Basically the edge that is connecting here, this side also its correspondence should be connecting. You have to keep this in mind. Listen, X is here now, we will see. Students, this is what we have got. I will take R. What I will take? X to R. Here this side I came to R from X. Clear? Here C is in this side. So where will I go from C? I can't go to E, right? Therefore, I will go to H. Students, where will I go? To H. But you have to check that here if X is connecting with R, so here also C should connect with H. Also verify that here is no other connection, okay? Now we will talk about P here. The problem with P is that on which should it go or correspond with, because here R went to H. Here the R we have correspond with which one? It correspond with H. Is this clear? Because we have C here and H is connecting with it. We can have two directions. Either this or this can be it. So the biggest problem is if we write I or G. So students, here's a way. The way is P is connecting with which one? So here P is connecting with R and we have P connecting with V, right? But because V is also connecting to D, you can see it, right? V is connecting to D. And R is connecting with which? It is connecting with H. So which edge is connecting D and H? So which edge connect D and H? We will get I as answer. So this will go to I. Is that clear? Now from P where we'll go? We will go to S. If this side we are moving S, then this side from I to J, we have got the direction. So there's no need to check it again and again. So from S, where will we go? To Q. So on this side from J to where? It will go to F, right? Now students, where will we go from Q? We will go to Z. This side from F to G. Now you can see all of these is what? It is connected, right? Now we need to check our vertices are connected. And if there is a 1-to-1 correspondence between the edges, see here Q and Z, if Q and Z is connecting here, therefore F and G should also connect. C, F and G are also connected. If we talk about S and Q, so S and Q are connecting. Yes, S and Q are connecting here. Therefore, here J and F should also connect, right? So like this, you can see edges and vertex are corresponding with each other. So it simply means these two graphs are what? These graphs are isomorphic. Moving on, this question says check the isomorphism of two graphs. You need to find out if these two graphs are isomorphic or not. And there is a problem. Listen, the vertex we have is how much? Here it is 4. And the vertex here is how much? It is 6. So it will not be a 1-to-1 correspondence. Because for 1-to-1 correspondence, vertex and the edges of both need to be equal. The degree should be the same. Okay? And 1-to-1 correspondence should be in the edges and vertex. But here the vertex are not equal. So these two graphs are not isomorphic. Let's move on. Next question show that the graph are isomorphic. You have to prove these two graphs are isomorphic. This is same like previous question, question number 2. Here we have the number of vertex equal in both. It's 8 here and 8 here. Number of edges is also equal. And here degree of each vertex is 3, 3. That means all three conditions are satisfied. Now we will see here which edge is connected with whom. Now we'll talk about 1-to-1 correspondence. So first of all, we will take A. A is correspondence to what? Let's say it is correspondence with U. Then B is correspondence with whom? It corresponds with P. Because this edge and this edge should be connected. Now let's take C. C is correspondence to? It's correspondence to Q. Now we'll talk about D. D is correspondence to? It's correspondence to R. Students, see here D is going on H. It is going inward. like this. So students, this side we will connect R with V. This will also go inward. So we do it like this. Next, we'll talk about H. Now this will be of H. After H, we will see G, right? Now the G. So we will take G here, okay? So here G is connected with H here, this side. So here V should be connected to what? I will take T, okay? I will take T because T was left here. Is this clear? Now let's talk about F. We have got this G. So after G, we will talk about F, right? So this is given to us. Now I will take this S, clear? So this will go to S, okay? Now students, we have already got F and G here. So after this, let's take E here. If we take E here, so this side I will take W, clear? So almost each are connecting. Now you can see F is connecting with E here. F is connecting with E, so S should be connecting with W. Yes, S is connecting with W. So here we have a one-to-one correspondence between the vertices and the edges. If you want to check any edge, like C is connecting with D, so Q should be connecting with R. You can see C is connecting with D. So students, QR is also connecting. Therefore, we will have one-to-one correspondence between edges and vertex. This means that here these two graphs will be isomorphic to each other. So thank you so much for watching me. There are more videos on graph theory. You can watch it here. The complete playlist is uploaded. I am uploading many short tricks on my new channel. You can go and check out here. You can subscribe to my new channel here and you can follow me on Instagram. Thank you so much for watching me. Like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much, everyone. Thank you. Bye-bye.